Hi, it's Patrick here from thegarageBandguide.com. Whether it's spending a bloody fortune on the latest and greatest audio unit plugin that'll take your projects to the next level, or grabbing a cool wee freebie, adding to GarageBand's built-in arsenal of plugins is something that most GarageBand for Mac users will do at some point. As good as broadening your sonic horizons is, when things go wrong, it sucks. Going to the trouble of installing your effect or instrument plugin only to find that it's nowhere to be seen once you load up GarageBand is a bit of a nightmare. In this video, I'll show you how to fix it. So what we're going to do here is force GarageBand to rescan for any audio unit effect or instrument plugins that you have installed on your Mac. This is the same scan that GarageBand does when you first download and install it. And before we go any further, I should point out that this isn't going to break, mess up or brick GarageBand, your Mac or anything else. But if you're not 100% comfortable giving this process a try, then by all means, perform a Time Machine backup before attempting. And I don't need to tell you that because, of course, if you're anything like me, you perform regular Time Machine backups anyway, right? First off, dive into your Mac's library folder. As of macOS 10 Lion, Apple have hidden it away in the Go tab of the Finder toolbar, but you can access it easily by clicking on Go in the toolbar at the top and then holding the Option key. Click on Library once it appears. Then navigate to User Library Preferences. And delete the file com.apple.audio.infohelper.plist. Next, navigate to User Library Caches Audio Unit Cache and delete any of the following files: com.apple.audiounits.cache, com.apple.audiounits.sandboxed.cache. And that's it. Restart your Mac, and when you open GarageBand, it will rescan for any installed plugins, including any that, for whatever reason, didn't show up before. Disclaimer though, this process doesn't magically make older 32-bit plugins available for use again. That ship has well and truly sailed, my friend. So there you have it, that's how to fix the issue of plugins not showing up in GarageBand. If you're just getting started with GarageBand on Mac or want a refresh on the basics, you can download my quick start guide absolutely free. I'll put a link to that in the description below. I've been Patrick from thegarageBandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.